Adani has been fighting to hide details of what it told the Queensland government about the risk of pollution to the Great Barrier Reef ahead of Cyclone Debbie in 2017, according to conservationists. They say documents and a series of emails obtained through Freedom of Information laws appear to show the company and the Queensland government knew the pollution would be so bad it would break the law. Peter McCallum is the coordinator of the Mackay Conservation Group, which made the FOI request, and he joins us now via Skype from Mackay. Hi, Peter, welcome. What do you say Adani did wrong?
Sorry, I missed that bit, sorry.
What did you say Adani did wrong?
Well, what they did was they applied for a temporary emissions licence during Cyclone Debbie that hit the coasts last year. And that licence was issued to them after the cyclone crossed the coast. So it sort of seemed to be a retrospective licence to increase their level of pollution. So they got a tripling in the level of pollution they could emit into the Great Barrier Reef, and then they exceeded that new limit by 800%. It turns out from the documents that we have obtained through the Freedom of Information laws here in Queensland that Adani was well aware that the water that they were going to emit into the Great Barrier Reef World Heritage Area was highly polluted and was likely to cause harm to the environment.
How hard was it to get hold of these documents?
Well, it's taken us over a year. We applied for the documents back in April 2017, and Adani's fought us every step of the way. They've applied for internal and external reviews of the decision by the government to release those documents to us, and they probably could have gone further, but they eventually decided that, based on the Information Commissioner's decision, that there was absolutely no reasonable grounds for not releasing this information to us, that they wouldn't proceed to a court hearing on it.
What made you think that there was something amiss about the release of water from the plant?
Well, at first, you know, like we were a bit puzzled by the idea that a temporary emissions license could be amended, and especially after the fact. So we wanted to find out, you know, what was going on there, and some of the information may have contained information about what level of pollutants were in the water, and that's exactly what we found out.
What should Adani have done to safely dispose of the water? Because the water, it seems, was going to get out anyway because Cyclone Debbie was about to hit.
That's right, yeah. So Adani really hasn't done any work to protect that the sensitive wetland environments nearby or the Great Barrier Reef World Heritage Area from pollution from its site. Like, there have been 23 cyclones over the past 50 years that have crossed within 100 kilometres of that site, including Cyclone Debbie, and Adani has not done any work to protect the environment. What they're doing right now is applying for an increase in their licence to export coal through that terminal by 10 million tonnes per year, and that'll cost them, you know, like $45 million to do. But they could spend that money on protecting the environment instead, which we think is something that the people of Australia and the people of the world think they should be doing.
Adani denies it acted wrongly, Peter, saying, quote, "We complied with the limits imposed by the temporary emissions licence issued by the regulator and no breach occurred." We've heard your response to that, but what's your next step now?
Well, what we're doing is calling on the Environment Minister in Queensland to prosecute Adani for their admitted 806 milligrams per litre of emissions, which exceeded their licence by over 700 milligrams per litre. You know, she should be getting her department to take them to court over that. If they don't do it soon, then the time period will expire and Adani won't pay 1 cent for that serious breach of the environmental law. Now, the Environment Minister was saying just last week in the Queensland Parliament that Queensland has some of the strongest environmental measures in Australia, if not the world. Well, we'd like to see them enforced.
Have you made any approach to the Queensland Government yet?
Look, we've spoken with the government on many occasions over this matter, and we think that, you know, like, it's time for the government to act.
Peter McCallum, thank you.
Thanks, Rob.